Good morning, students. It is video number 14 of class 5 science. In this video, we will revise full first term syllabus and I will give you revision test from the full syllabus. First chapter, skeleton system, which we finish in video 1, 2 and 3, in which we studied that human body is made up of cells. When same type of cell join, they form tissue. Tissue, it form organ, and organ, it form organ system. Then we read the table in which different systems they have written: nervous system, skeleton system, muscular system, circulatory system, digestive system, respiratory system, excretory system, and reproductive system. And you know how many bones are present in an adult human body? 206. Then we read about the function of the skeleton system. It provides shape and support, protect delicate organ, help to bring about movement with the help of muscle attached to the bones. Then about bones, we have studied it is made up of calcium and phosphorus. Bones are not solid. It is composed of or filled with bone marrow, and bone marrow is a site of the production of red blood cells. Then we discussed about skull, that it is bony cage. It made up of 22 bones, 8 bones make the skull and 14 bones make the face. Only lower jaw is the only movable part of the skull. Backbone or spine or vertebral column, it is made up of 33 small bones. How many? 33. It is like a beads, and backbone protect the spinal cord. Cartilage is present between each vertebrae so that these small bones are able to slide over each other. It makes us possible to bend, twist and turn. And cartilage help the spinal cord to bear body weight, and cartilage also act like a cushion against a sudden jerk when we travel or doing some activity. That time we experience that jerk. Then we discuss about the ribs. 12 pairs of thin flat curved bones in the chest region form the rib cage. 10 bones are joined with the front bone, which is known as sternum or breast bone, whereas last two, they are not joined with the sternum or breast bone, so we call it as a floating ribs, and it protect heart and lungs. Then we discuss about kinds of joint. Some are immovable, some are movable. In case of movable joint, we hinge joint, ball and socket joint, then pivot joint, gliding joint. How we can care? These points we already discussed. Bones with the regular exercise, we can stay healthy and good. While sitting, standing, walking, our posture should be correct. We should take food rich in calcium. Second chapter, solid, liquid and gases. This chapter we discussed in video number 4, 5, 6 and 7. In this chapter we discuss what is matter. Anything that occupies space and has weight is called matter. Arrangement of molecule in case of solid, in case of liquid and in case of gases we discussed. Molecules are tightly arranged in solid, so solids, they have definite shape, definite volume. Molecules in the solid, they pack so tightly and intermolecular space is very less and intermolecular force is very small. In case of liquid, we studied about molecular arrangement, that liquid do not have definite shape. In which container we collect it, it acquire the shape of that container. They have definite volume, and we can't compress liquid and we can't compress solid also. About gases, we learnt that there is maximum intermolecular space and intermolecular force is negligible, so gases do not have definite shape and do not have definite volume, but we can compress the gases move with high pressure. Then we discussed about soluble impurities and insoluble impurities in water, how we can remove them to use the water. Purification method, how we can remove impurities from the soluble and insoluble form. Purification of water, how we can remove soluble impurity by boiling, by adding chlorine, potassium permanganate or by filtration method. And insoluble impurity by sedimentation. Sedimentation is followed by decantation, then decantation followed by filtration, and afterward we can put chlorine, potassium permanganate, so that we can kill the germs from the water and we can use it for drinking purpose. Then we come to know the composition of air: 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen and 1% other gases are present in the air. In 1%, 0.03% carbon dioxide and 0.001% helium, argon, neon, methane and many more gases are present in the air. Then we discussed about how does wind blow. When air get warm up due to the sunlight, it become lighter and move toward the upper side. At upper atmosphere it become cool. When it become cool down or cooler air, it come down to occupy the empty space. In this way wind is blowing on the earth. We discussed about sea breeze. At daytime it is sea breeze blow. Land get heated up faster than the water, and the air above the land get heated and rises up. The water in the sea is cool, so cool air blow down to take the place of the warm air. Similarly, we discussed about land breeze, in which warm air from the water it rises up at night time, cooler air it come down to fill the empty space on the land during the night. In this way land breeze is blue. Interdependence in living being, plants and animals, in which we discuss about biotic component. Biotic components are all living beings in the nature. Green plants are the producers, we know, because they prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. They take carbon dioxide from the air in the presence of sunlight and take water from soil, and in the presence of green pigment, that is chlorophyll, they prepare food in form of sugar. Animals are consumer because they cannot prepare their own food and depend on green plants directly or indirectly. Herbivore, these animals, they are the primary consumer because they depend on plants for food. Carnivores, these animals are those which kill and eat other animals. Some animals, they eat both plants and animals. Such animals are called omnivores. Some microorganisms like bacteria and fungi that decompose organic matter, so increase soil fertility, these are the decomposers which recycle nutrient in the environment. Some animal like vulture, hyena, these animals are those animals which eat dead animals, so we call these as scavenger. Dependence of animals on plants, we studied that all animals are depend on plants for food directly or indirectly and take oxygen from the plants. Similarly, plants also depend on animals. Plants take carbon dioxide breathed out by the animals. Decomposed body of animal act like the nutrients for the plants. animals help in seed dispersal, insects for pollination. Sun is the ultimate source of energy on the earth, and the sun energy is captured by green plants during the process of photosynthesis and flow into animals across a food chain. In food chain, herbs and plants are consumed by the primary consumer. We call them herbivore. Herbivores are consumed by carnivores, secondary consumers, decomposers. In this food chain, decomposer at last decomposes dead bodies of all living beings, plants, herbivores, carnivores, and turn in form of nutrient in the soil to increase the soil fertility. Then we discuss, if we remove all carnivores, what will be the effect on the food chain? Imbalance in nature. Then causes of imbalance in nature we discussed, that due to deforestation, and due to deforestation, global warming. Due to deforestation, it result in global warming, and forest fire also destroy, which make the animals homeless. Then hunting of animal for the body parts. These all causes imbalance in nature. This all we had already discussed. Then last chapter of first term syllabus, simple machine, we are discussed in video 11, 12 and 13. In this chapter we discussed about the simple machine, that what is a machine which make our work easier. In this we discuss why we use this. Because simple machine, it increase the amount of force supply, change the direction of force, and by increasing the speed of doing work. Then we discussed about six type of simple machine: lever, which have fulcrum, load, effort, three parts. Then we discussed load arm, what it is, the distance between load and fulcrum, and effort arm, distance between effort and fulcrum. In case of lever, we discussed three types of lever. First class lever, these example already we discussed. Second class lever, third class lever, inclined plane through which we can reduce the force and we can lift heavy weight. About screw, inclined plane wrapped into spiral threads so that it can hold the things firmly. About pulley, to pick up heavy load with the less force. It is two type: fixed pulley, then movable pulleys. Wedge, which having the sharp edge to cut the things. Wheel and axle, this all we discuss, that wheel firmly attached to a rod called axle form a simple machine called wheel and axle. I hope easily you are able to understand the fourth chapter of the first term. Now, revision test, you will do it in the notebook without cheating. So, note down the revision test for the first term. Define tendon, breeze, squinges and pulley. Fill ups. First, primary consumers are dash. Second, dash air is light and rises. Third, fill up. Dash is the longest and strongest bone in the body. Fourth, a dash is an inclined plane wrapped around a spiral. Third question answers. Third part. First, what is liver? Explain its parts. Second, distinguish between soluble and insoluble impurities. Third, how can we keep our bones healthy and strong? Fourth, draw diagram of photosynthesis. Fifth, give two examples. First, a decomposer. Second, omnivores. Sixth part, true false. Carnivores are secondary consumer. Second, a blade is an example of a wedge. Thank you.